Muslims have been baiting people for weeks and weeks and weeks to get a reaction. They haven't got a reaction, but now they have. They've got a tiny little shoulder shove. And listen to them. They're so desperate. They are so desperate for a narrative.
You're hiding behind
this little narrative. So absolutely desperate for a narrative, aren't you? And you think you've got it, but you haven't. Do you have no self-awareness? Do you have no self-awareness? Do you really think you're doing good dawah? Are you doing is this good dawah?
I'm not doing dawah.
What are you doing?
I'm not doing dawah.
Offering a prat.
Is
this dawah?
I'm exposing double
standards. No, it's dawah. He thinks it's dawah.
This is not dawah, right? I'm exposing double standards.
What is it then?
I'm exposing double standards. I'm exposing double standards.
Bollocks. Is it dawah or is it bollocks? Not that they could be the same.
I'm exposing double standards, right? Wait, when Muslims get hit, right? Why do you never speak
when
about it?
When Muslims get hit, is that a plural statement?
Why do you never speak about it?
Are you speaking in the plural?
Why do you never speak about it?
Are you speaking in the plural? Because it doesn't
condemn
happen.
Condemn Moses. Okay, condemn
it
Moses.
It doesn't happen. Condemn Moses. I condemn anyone condemn for hitting
condemn
anyone.
Go to him now. Condemn him.
Where is he?
Condemn
Bring him.
Him
over.
No, he's over there.
Bring him over.
Condemn him, look. Condemn him. I want to see you condemn him.
You're playing a silly game. You're not in the playground. Condemn him. Condemn him. I condemn any violence whatsoever.
You condemn him.
You condemn
his violence.
You condemn his violence.
Listen, I condemn all violence. Do you know the word all? It is yours, Tawid's, everyone.
Be specific.
I condemn all violence.
You condemn his violence.
I condemn my violence.
That's good.
I condemn my violence.
Because I'm not playing a stupid fucking game like you.
I condemn all violence.
That's good.
He condemned all violence.
So advise him. Advise him next time. Do not be violent.
He doesn't need my advice.
Okay. Let me just say, I ask everybody here, right? This is a question. What would you do? What would you do if a couple of weeks ago a man threatened you for no reason?
Avoid him. That's all
no
I'll
reason.
Do.
No, I haven't finished the question. I haven't finished the question. If a man a couple of weeks ago threatened you, and then the next time you see him, you haven't talked to him before, the next time you see him, he's in your face, you try to avoid him, he's in your face, and he's insulting you. Steve was there, you were both saying,
Go to the police.
Yeah, no.
If someone threatened you,
I haven't even finished the question. You're too quick. You're too quick. I haven't finished the question. I haven't finished the question.
The police are here because of your brother.
A couple of weeks ago.
They're not here because of us. They're here because of your brother. You're laughing.
Calm your passion. All I'm saying is don't threaten a man a couple of weeks, yeah? And then the next time you see him, you come in his face, you put your hand and insult him, and he goes to you and says,
walk away, go to
no,
the police.
And then you go to him,
deploy, as I said.
And you say, don't do that to me again. And then he says, what are you going to do about it? Of course you're gonna expect a reaction. Now, I was in the wrong.
If you were smart enough, you would have backed up.
I was in the wrong. I shouldn't have hit him. I should have touched him.
Hear it?
Loud
and clear.
Shot away and tell your brother.
Let me just say this. There is nothing anyone could say to me in this park that would let me do that again. Not even that same person.
It's good, man.
But don't carry on like you're Tony Montana.
Exactly.
Don't carry on like you're Tony Montana, like you're a gangster.
So
and then the next time,
now.
Yeah, and then something happens to you, and then the next time something
Gary,
happens
Moses.
To you, you run
don't
off like you're Mickey
cover.
Mouse.
Moses,
you run off like a stick.
Don't judge a book by its cover.
No.
The guy has
no,
a mask, right?
No.
He may look violent, but he's not violent.
Why would you come here in a mask?
Why?
So what? Don't come here. Is he shy?
How many other people?
That's
right.
How many other people?
Why is he wearing a mask?
It's his right to wear a
mask. Why? Because he's a violent thug.
No, but
thugs.
Steve,
thugs.
Steve,
pure and simple.
He can't wear
and simple.
He can't wear
and simple.
It's right.
And he's got
Here's the point. You can come here in a ski mask.
Freedom, mate.
When you come in a ski mask.
Freedom.
When you come in a ski mask.
Freedom.
No.
Is that man on
grinder? No.
Is the mask on grinder?
He can come in a ski mask. But when you come to ski mask,
Steve, you're a cuckold, man.
When you come to ski mask,
shut up. Who did you only ever hear that from? Shut up.
You're a cuck, mate.
Is that a new word?
When you wear a ski mask, don't carry on like you're Tony Montana. Don't carry on like you're Genghis Khan. Yeah? No, sorry. Don't carry on like you're a peaceful man when you act aggressive and the people react to you. Don't come across like... If you're in a ski mask, don't be aggressive at the same time. That's what I'm saying. You know? Because people will react in a negative way.